Adam has a bag containing 9 balls, and these are numbered from 1 to 9. And Adam takes a ball at random from the bag and replaces it. So this is experiment with replacement. In with replacement, the total of number of the balls remain same every time. Find the probability that the ball has an odd numbers. So out of 9 balls, there are 5 odd balls. Probability is 5 over 9. And in the same way, if we take 2 odd balls and both have the, so with replacement, so the probability is 25 over 81. The third, second part of the B is work out the probability that the odd number, that the one ball is odd and the second is even with replacement. So out of 9, 5, there are 5 odd balls. And as the experiment is with replacement, so the total ball remains same. And there are 4 even balls out of 9. So after multiplication, so it is 21 over 81. 20 over 81. The C part is about the experiment that is without replacement. And you take 2 balls from 9 without replacement, work out the probability that the 2 balls are either odd or both even. So either mean we have to add the probabilities. So in the first case, suppose the first odd will be, in the first case there will be 5 odd balls. In the second, we will have total 8 balls left and the 4 odd balls there. Now, there is second possibility that even ball, there are 4 even balls out of 9. After taking 1, there are total 8 balls and the 3 even balls left. And after simplification, and the probability is 4 over 9. This is very simple algebraic question. This is an equation. Just using the cross multiply and solving the equation, we will get the, this will become quadratic equation because there is a y square term. After simplification, we will get this quadratic equation, and then using the factorization method, we can easily find the 2 possible values of y. And the factors are 3 and 2. And if we add these two, we have to subtract these two factors, 3 minus 2, then after factorizing, and these are the factors, and solving these factors will give us y minus 3 and plus 2. The B part is we have to make T the subject of the formula. Just cross multiply first. Taking t common, and after simplification, t will be equal to 2p minus 1 divided by 4 plus p. The c part is, it is a single fraction and we have to simplify this. Here we will factorize numerator and denominator. And after factorizing both numerator and denominator, we will cancel out the common factor. That will give us the simplified fraction. The numerator is a quadratic expression. We will factorize this. So we have to make the factor of 8 multiplied by 3, 24, and we will pick that pair of factor of 24, which by when we add those two factors, that will give us the answer 14. So 12 times 2 is the right pair of factor, and we will use these two to factorize the numerator. In the denominator, we will use the identity a square minus b square. The first is x square and the second is square of 4. 16 is square of 4. And just factorizing the numerator, now applying the identity a square minus b square, in the denominator it is x minus 4 times x plus 4. Some people also call this identity conjugate of binomial. Now in the numerator x minus 4 is common. What left? 3x minus 2. And in the denominator, we have the same x minus 4 times x plus 4. And you can see here x minus 4 is common in the numerator, and in the denominator, it will be cancelled out. And the what left is a simplified fraction of the question. This is circle question. Here the center is O and AC is the diameter of the circle, and the two line AC and ED are parallel lines, and the rest is given on the diagram. We have to find angle ACB. So let's mark on the diagram, this is angle ACB and we have to find it. You can see that this angle ACB, as AC is the diameter, so the angle at B will be the 90 degree. The property is angle subtended by the diameter. So this is right angle triangle. So 90 minus 52 will be 38. So this angle is 38. Degree, 38 degree. The second part is find angle AEF with reason. AEF, this is the angle. We have to find this. You can see that this angle is subtended by the arc A and B, because 1 foot of the angle is at point A and the second foot of the angle is at point B. So this red portion of the arc has subtended angle at C, and we have to see whether the same arc has subtended angle on the circumference. Yes, the same arc AB has subtended the angle on E as well. So the angle, according to the angle in the same segment, both angle are same, that is 38. The reason is angle subtended by the same segment. So sometimes we also call it angle subtended by the same arc. This can also be given as reason. And third part is find angle CDE. CDE. So CDE, we have to find this angle. And you can see the diagram AED C and B. BEDC is a cyclic quadrilateral. In cyclic quadrilateral, the opposite angles are supplementary. So the opposite angle of angle D is 68. Therefore, 180 minus 68 will be the angle D. And the reason is the opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. The angle is 112. Fourth part is find angle BCD. D, C and D, this whole angle. And you have observed that there are two lines parallel, and we have not used that concept. You can see the angle at D and an angle at C are the interior angles of the parallel lines, and interior angles of the parallel lines are supplementary. So this angle is 180 minus 112, that is 68, and the total angle C is 68 plus 38. That is 106 degrees. The next question of the same question is B part. We have to find the size of the largest angle in this pentagon. First, we want to know what is the total sum of the interior angles of a pentagon. To find the sum of interior angles of a pentagon, we have the formula n minus 2 into 180. N is the number of the sides, and there are 5 sides. So 5 minus 2 is 3, and 3 times 180 will give us 540. Therefore, the interior angles of a pentagon, the sum of the interior angles of pentagon is 540. Once we have the sum of the interior angle, we will add all these interior angles, that these all, the sum of all these interior angle will be equal to 140. So 2x, 2x, 4 plus 3, 7 plus x, 8x. 8x plus 124 is equal to 540. And after solving this single variable equation, we will get x. So the x is 52, but we have to find the size of the largest angle. So in x, 3x is the largest, and we have to see whether 3 out of 3x and 124, which one is the largest. First we have to find 3x. So 52 times 3 is 156, and 156 is also is larger than 124. So the largest angle of pentagon is 156 degrees. C part, the angle of the quadrilateral are given correct to the nearest degree. So when it is said that it is nearest degree, it could be a question of upper bound and lower bound. We have to find the lower bound for the value of y. So to find the value of y, we have to take the difference of all the interior angles, rest of the interior angles from 360. So as it is the nearest degree, we have will divide, when it is nearest degree, we will always divide 1 by 2, that is 0.5. So to find the difference, to find the lower bound of the difference, so we have to subtract the upper bounds of all the rest of the interior angle from 360. So therefore we have to first find the upper bound of each given angle. So we have to add 0.5 into every angle to get the upper bound. So the y is basically the difference of all the sum of the all the angles from 360. So to find the lower bound of y, we have to subtract the upper bounds of all the angles, the sum of the upper bounds of the all the angles from 360. So after doing this, we will get the lower bound of the angle y. So the lower bound for the value y is 105.5 degree. Section B, question number 7. So there is 2 points lies on the line L, and we have to find the equation of line L. And equation of line L is y is equal to mx plus c, and we have to find m, m is gradient, and c is the y-intercept. And the formula of the gradient is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. We just plug in the values of y1 and y2, x2 and x1. So we mark the x1 and y1, x2 and y2. After simplification, the gradient is minus 2. And if the point is 0, 5, in such type of points, the y-intercept is 5. Therefore, equation of a straight line L is minus 2x plus 5. In the second part of question 7a, find the equation of line M that is parallel to the L and passing through the point minus 2, 3. The parallel lines always have the same gradient, so the gradient of line M will be also minus 2. And putting the value of M in equation y is equal to mx plus c, To find C, we have to plug in the value of this point, minus 2 and 3, into the equation. We'll put 3 in Y and minus 2 into X. And remember, use always bracket when you substitute points. And after simplification, the Y-intercept will be 3 minus 4, because minus 2 is plus 4. When plus 4 comes on the other side, it will become again minus 4. Equation of line M is minus 2x minus 1. And the B part of the question 7 is, we have a function and we have a table of that function. We have to find the missing value in the table, and that has one mark. We just plug in 6 into the function, because it is paper number 2, so we can use calculator. So it is y is equal to x, and x is 6. So the final answer is 3.5. Using the scale 2 cm to 1 unit on both axes, draw a horizontal x-axis from 0 to 7 and a vertical y-axis from 0 to 4. And remember, x-axis is called horizontal axis and y-axis is called vertical axis. We have to plot the graph from 0.5 to 6. Just observing the table, we have to see where to draw x-axis and y-axis. And the scale is 2 cm to 1 unit. It means after every 2 cm we have to mark 1. two, three like that. The first point is 0.5 and 3.5. After plotting all these three, all the points of the table, be careful by plotting the points. The first point should be on the left hand side, one step left hand side. After plotting the points, we will join the points with a smooth curve used by hand. It should be a smooth curve. Now we have to draw the tangent, and then we will estimate the gradient of that tangent, and it should be at 0.1 comma 1. So this is 0.1 comma 1. A tangent is a line that touches the curve at only one point. So this is our required tangent line. Now to find the gradient of this line, we have to need another point. So we are taking x-intercept as a second point. X-intercept is a point where the line cuts x-axis. So that point is 1.5 comma 0. So using the two points, we will find the gradient, and the formula of the gradient is y1 minus y2 over x1 minus x2. So just plugging in or putting the values, we will get the gradient of the tangent line. And doing simplification, calculator is also allowed. We can also use calculator instead of doing mental calculation, mental math. So the gradient is -2. The last part, the fourth part, use the graph to solve the equation. x plus x 3 over x is equal to 5. So to solve this, and you have to use the graph. So using the graph to solve the equation, if we compare both the function, this one and the given equation, we can see that the left hand side has not the same expression as we used for graph. So we will add minus 3 on both sides of the equation to make the left hand side same as we use for drawing the graph. Now the left hand side is exactly the same function as we have used for graph. So on the right hand side, now we have 2, which is y is equal to 2. Now we will plot this line y is equal to 2 on the graph. Y is equal to 2 is a horizontal line which cuts y-axis at 2. Now we can see that this line and the previous graph cuts at 2 points, and we will find the x coordinate of these two intersecting points. So the x coordinate of this point, let's mark this x coordinate of this point, which is 4.1, 2, 3, 4.3, and the x coordinate of this intersecting point is, let's mark that on the x axis, it is 0.8. This point is 4.3 and this point is 0.8. If we count the small boxes, so this mark is 8 point on the right hand side of origin. So this is 0.8 and the second coordinate is 4.3. The second point of the x is 4.3. Therefore, the solution of the equation is 0.8 and 4.3. So we will use the x coordinate of the point of intersection. Question number 8 is about mensuration. This is a solid A, and both have the same radius, and the radius is 6. And the total height is 18. Therefore, the height of the cone is, show that the slant height of the cone is x centimeter, which is x centimeter, is equal to 13.4. And the answer should be up to 1 decimal place. The total height is 18. Therefore, the height of the cone is 18 minus 6, 12 centimeter. And the radius is 6. So now we would use Pythagoras theorem to find the slant height. And here the slant height x is the hypotenuse of the right angle triangle. And after taking the square root on both sides, we will get the slant height. So first, always use the complete answer on your calculator, and then it is better to write 4 significant figure first and at the end convert that into 3 significant answer, or as per instruction of the question. In this question, answer should be one decimal place. So it is 13.1 centimeter. Sorry, 13 point, sorry, it is 13.42 and 13.4 is the final answer. Be careful writing the answer correctly. Okay. And B part is calculate the total surface area of the solid, which is the sum of the curved surface area of the cone plus the curved surface area of the hemisphere. The curved surface area of the cone is pi RL, and the curved surface area of the hemisphere is 2 pi R square. Because it is hemi, half of the full sphere, so it is 2 pi R square. By adding these two, we will get the total surface area of the solid. It is better don't put the value of pi in the middle of the working. Once you have simplified the working, then you should put the value of pi. This is very helpful in doing the calculations. So it is better to use the full value of the calculator instead of rounding, or you can also use 4 significant value instead of 3 significant value. If you are using your answer of the previous part into the next part. And always do the working in the middle of the question using more than 3 significant figure. Once we adding these two, now at the end of the working we should put the value of pi now. It is better to use the value of pi from the calculator. So after writing it from the screen of your calculator, now you should round this up to 3 significant figures. Which is 479 centimeter square. The C part, calculate the volume of the solid A. The volume of the solid A is the volume of the cone plus volume of the hemisphere. Volume of the cone is 1/3 pi R square H, and volume of the sphere is 4 over 3 pi r cube, and it is hemisphere, but by dividing by 2 will give us 2 over 3 pi r cube. Now adding these two will give us the volume of the cone, volume of the solid A. Putting the value of radius and the height of the cone. Radius is 6 in both cone and hemisphere, and the height is 12. don't put the value of pi in the middle of the question, put the value of pi at the end of the question. So it is 14 144 pi. The D part is solid A is one of the set of three geometrically similar solids. So this solid A is similar to solid B and C, and the ratio of the heights of all these three is 2:6:1. And we have to calculate the surface area of the solid B correct to three significant figure. So as the area of the solid A is already calculated and solid A and B are similar, so we will use the similarity formula of area, that is area of the solid B and area of the solid A is equal to the ratio of their length, which is 6/2. And then remember, take the square because they are similar, and in case of area we take square, if we take the ratio of the volume we take cube, and in the same way if we take the ratio of the masses we also take cube. So don't forget to take square, and we should use 479.16. remember, we should use the, if you're using the answer of the previous part, use it up to more than three significant figure solution. So we will use 479.16 instead of 479. This will give us more accuracy in our final solution. This is very important point. So after simplifying inside the bracket first, then we take the square and then cross multiplying, you will get the area of the object B, which is similar to object A. So first we write this answer on our answer space, and then after that we will round it up to three significant figures. It will be 4310 centimeter square up to three significant figure. In the next part, calculate the volume of solid C correct to three significant figures. Solid C is also similar to solid A, so we will use again similarity formula of volume, that is volume of C over volume of A is equal to the ratio of C and A, the ratio of the length of C and A, which is 1/2. And then we take cube because it is volume of similar objects, and we will use the volume of A which we have calculated earlier. Don't use three significant figure, use more than three significant figure solution. Taking the cube here and then cross multiply, we will get the volume of solid C. And it is 113.1, and after three significant figure converting into three sig fig, it is 103 centimeter cube.